Whether you choose Granny Smith or Red Delicious, the apple, the staple of fall foods.
And you know that adage, an apple a day keeps the doctor away? Hold some weight as the seasons change.
Well, you know, October is dedicated to apples. And, you know, one of the stars of the fall harvest could help you reach new heights as you get into the out there.
Certified nutritionist Karina Heinrich joins us now to help us spice up our autumn offerings. Karina, always great to have you. So let's talk apples, since apples are my favorite fruit. But what do apples provide our bodies as we look to switch to a healthier diet in the fall?
Yeah, absolutely. Apples are amazing for fiber. They are chock full of all of those immunity boosters that we need going into fall. So you definitely want to add them into your day-to-day diet.
Now, when we talk about the picky eaters, how do we get them to kind of gobble up all the apples that we have in the basket?
Absolutely. And I have three of those picky eaters in my home. I have three after-school favorites that we have at home. After-school apple rings. You just need three apples, a variety of toppings like peanut butter, almond butter, even Nutella, cream cheese, pumpkin seeds, chocolate chips, raisins. So you just core your apples 1/4 wide rings, put toppings in little small bowls, and let your kids go to town decorating these rings. I also love yummy cinnamon apple chips. They're going to disappear almost as quickly as you make them. They're perfect for healthy snacks, easy to take on the road. You just bake apple slices topped with a little honey and cinnamon at a really low temperature for a long time, which dehydrates the apples, but retains all of those nutrients. My personal fave is a sweet and creamy peanut butter apple sandwich. So you just mix peanut butter with ricotta cheese in a bowl until smooth, add vanilla extract, cinnamon, honey, spread it on whole wheat, and add thinly sliced apples for extra crunch. So amazing.
That is such a great idea. I think the kids would love it.
The apple chips, yes. I'm going for that.
Yeah. You were like, no to the peanut butter. Yeah, that's okay. There's plenty
something
of options.
For everyone.
Yeah, something for everybody. Yes. Now, I mean, look, nothing beats like a bite out of a fresh apple, especially one just freshly picked. But what about meals that we can pair up apples with?
Yes. So apples are an incredible addition to meats like pork chops, pork loin, even turkey stuffing this Thanksgiving. But if you like soups and are looking for an amazing vegetarian option, one of my favorite combinations using all of fall's harvest is a healthy roasted pumpkin apple carrot soup. This soup allows the naturally sweet flavors of apples to really shine. And if you grew spices over the spring and summer, pressed sage makes a great garnish as well. So you're using everything from fall.
That sounds so good too. Yeah. All right, I've got my meal planning done for like the rest of the week, I feel like. You know, as temperatures fall, warming up with apples is a good way to sort of get them in. We love cider. Mm-hmm. Is cider healthy?
Yes, I actually have one of the best combinations to make on a chilly fall night. Spiced cranberry apple cider that you warm up on your stovetop for just 10 minutes. And it's so full of flavors and immunity boosters, slightly tangy, a little sweet. You're using apple cider, 100% cranberry juice, honey, whole cloves, whole allspice, and cinnamon sticks broken into pieces. And for the adults in the house, you can try a fun apple sangria that will take you well into the holiday season. So many amazing, easy options.
Wow, I need to get the paper out and start writing down these recipes. Yeah. This sounds delicious. All right, now we talked about apples being pretty good for kids, but of course, reading is as well. How are you combining those two in your new book?
Yes, so I have a new book out called Andy the Candy Witch, which focuses on kindness and accepting everyone's differences, but really showing kids that they don't need to finish the whole candy bag in one night. So it's about moderation. And it's about, obviously, like I showed you today, kind of combining things and doing the right things, especially when it comes to trick-or-treating and eating all that candy.
It's perfect timing for that to come out. Yeah, I saw that, and I thought I was very excited for you. And what a great message that we all could use, actually. I mean, everything in moderation, right?
Exactly. Yeah. No, it's the trick-or-treating can get a little out of hand, and it's a little spooky having a mom as a nutritionist. So my kids know that they pick their favorites and move on.
I bet. So today in our poll question on the show, Karina, we're asking our viewers about how they most like to consume apples, like to eat them raw, take a bite out of them, applesauce or apple pie or apple juice or cider. So we want to know what you think. What would you vote for?
I go raw. I mean, if I could pick it right off the apple tree, that would be my go-to. So raw, add a little almond butter on the side. That is my absolute favorite.
Yeah.
There you go. That first bite, that nice crunch is always
first
a good
bite. Exactly.
Certified nutritionist Karina Heinrich, thank you so much for joining us.
Thank you. You can check out
the Karina Method on Twitter and Instagram for ways to spice up your fall diet plans, and check out her book too.
Yeah.